Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Iowa State University is pleased and honored to welcome family and friends of our graduates to Iowa State's commencement ceremony for fall 2011. Today's commencement ceremony recognizes the newest graduates in Iowa State University's proud 153-year history of academic achievement, excellence, and service. The graduates will process as members of the delegations of their prospective colleges, led by their college dean, a student marshal presenting the college banner, and his or her faculty escort. Members of the assembly may remain seated during the procession of the candidates. It is our privilege to present to you the graduates, candidates from the Graduate College.
Thank you.
prepares for graduation from the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences. Graduation from the College of Business. Privileged to present to you the candidates for graduation from the College of Design. Graduation from the College of Engineering. Thank you. privileged to present to you the candidates for graduation from the College of Human Sciences. It is our privilege to present to you the candidates for graduation from the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences. Signaling the official beginning of our commencement, the University Mace, carried by Lead Faculty Marshal, University Professor Daniel Robinson, precedes the President. We ask that the candidates for graduation and the members of the Assembly please rise for the presentation of colors and the procession of members of the Iowa State University Academic Community, led by President Gregory Geoffroy. presentation of colors by the Naval Reserve Officer Training Corps Color Guard.
Please join me in the singing of our national anthem.
Please be seated. Graduates, family, and friends, I am pleased and honored to introduce Dr. Gregory Geoffroy, President of Iowa State University.
I am delighted to welcome you to Iowa State University's 2011 Fall Commencement Ceremony. Commencement is the most important and significant ceremony that a university holds. For our graduates, it represents the culmination of years of hard work and the beginning of an all-new and exciting journey. For the family and friends of our graduates, it's a time to share in the success that these graduating students have achieved, and to be recognized as well for the wonderful support that they have provided through the years. And for Iowa State University, today represents the successful completion of our most important responsibility to society, to educate the next generation of scholars and leaders. We take great pride in that accomplishment, and in the achievement by our newest graduates of this very significant educational milestone. I'd now like to introduce the members of the platform party, and I'd ask them to stand as I introduce them, and I'd ask you to hold your applause until all have been introduced. Dr. Benjamin Allen, President of the University of Northern Iowa, honorary degree recipient and our commencement speaker. Dr. Elizabeth Hoffman, Executive Vice President and Provost. Mr. Warren Madden, Vice President for Business and Finance. Dr. Thomas Hill, Vice President for Student Affairs. Dr. Kath Ann Kress, Vice President for Extension and Outreach. Dr. David Holger, Associate Provost for Academic Programs and Dean of the Graduate College. Dr. Charlotte Bronson, Associate Vice President for Research and Economic Development. James Dorsett, Interim Dean of Students. Mr. Jeffrey Johnson, President of the Iowa State University Alumni Association. Dr. Lob Hira, Raisbeck Dean of the College of Business. Dr. Wendy Winterstein, Endowed Dean of the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences. Dr. Pamela White, Dean of the College of Human Sciences. Mr. Luis Rico Gutierrez, Dean of the College of Design. Dr. Jonathan Wicker, Dean of the College of Engineering. Dr. Lisa Nolan, Stephen Julesgaard, Dean of the College of Veterinary Medicine. Dr. David Oliver, Interim Dean of the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences. Dr. Olivia Madison, Dean of the Library. Dr. Stephen Freeman, Faculty Senate President. Ms. Kathleen Jones, Associate Vice President for Student Affairs and University Registrar, and the distinguished faculty representing academic departments. Please join me in recognizing them.
Dr. Elizabeth Hoffman, Executive Vice President and Provost of the University, will now make a special presentation.
As many of you know, Dr. Gregory Geoffroy is stepping down as President of Iowa State University after 10 and a half years of service next month. He has served as president during difficult times, and he's led the university to many stellar achievements and historic milestones. Dr. Geoffroy's leadership has been exceptional. He has strengthened all aspects of the university, and most especially its academic quality. His collegial and collaborative leadership style has proven most effective in marshaling strong support for the university, both within the institution and from our many external constituents. As an example, I would call your attention to a resolution honoring President Geoffroy from the Iowa Board of Regents that is printed in today's commencement program. This support has resulted in a much stronger and more effective university, and he can leave the presidency knowing that it is much better for his leadership. We also want to thank his wife, Kathy, for all that she has done these past 10 and a half years as First Lady of the University, much of it behind the scenes. She's been an important part of Dr. Geoffroy's presidency, and she too will be much missed. I have had the pleasure of knowing Greg and Kathy Geoffroy for 18 years and of working with Greg as Executive Vice President and Provost for the past 5 years. And I know I speak for the entire university family, its faculty, staff, administrators, students, alumni, and many friends when I say thank you to Greg and Kathy Geoffroy for all they have done for Iowa State University. And now I would like the Geoffroys to come forward for a special presentation. One of President Geoffroy's top priorities has been to continuously improve the academic quality of the university, and in particular, the quality of the faculty, because they are the academic heart of the institution. This was a primary emphasis of the recently completed fundraising drive, Campaign Iowa State with Pride and Purpose, which had a goal of doubling the number of prestigious named faculty positions to attract top new talent and keep outstanding faculty here. Thanks to President Geoffroy's leadership, we have exceeded that goal, and there are now 162 such positions at Iowa State, more than double the number when he arrived. As part of this effort, President and Mrs. Geoffroy also made a personal commitment to establish the Geoffroy Faculty Fellowship to assist a young faculty member to advance his or her career, and that fellowship has supported some truly outstanding young faculty members at Iowa State. We have a tradition here that when a faculty member is appointed to an endowed position, he or she receives a medallion as a symbol of that high office to wear as long as he or she is in that position. The donor who created the position also receives a medallion as a permanent memento, an expression of appreciation from the university. The Geoffroys never received a medallion in recognition of the Geoffroy Faculty Fellowship, and it is my honor at this time to present the medallion to them.
Dr. Elizabeth Hoffman, Executive Vice President and Provost of the University, will now confer the honorary degree.
At today's ceremony, Iowa State University is privileged to bestow its 133rd honorary degree in the university's history. Dr. Stephen A. Freeman, President of the Faculty Senate, will introduce the distinguished recipient of the honorary degree to President Geoffroy.
Dr. Benjamin Allen, please stand. President Geoffroy, on behalf of the faculty of Iowa State University, the Faculty Senate has recommended and the Board of Regents, State of Iowa, has approved the award of the honorary degree Doctor of Humane Letters to Dr. Benjamin Allen. Benjamin Allen has been president of the University of Northern Iowa since 2006. He received his bachelor's degree in business economics from Indiana University and master's and PhD degrees in economics from the University of Illinois. He was a member of the Washington State faculty from 1974 to 1979, including a year as a Brookings Economic Policy Fellow in the U.S. Department of Transportation Office of Transportation Regulatory Policy. He joined the Iowa State faculty in 1979 and served as Dean of the College of Business from 1994 to 2001, Interim Vice President for External Affairs in 2001-2002, and Vice President for Academic Affairs and Provost from 2002 to 2006. Dr. Allen is a nationally known researcher and educator in transportation and logistics, with particular expertise in regulatory reform, deregulation, and public transportation policy. In 1988, he was named the first distinguished professor in business at Iowa State. In 2007, Dr. Allen was appointed to the Presidential Advisory Committee for the National Commission of University Accountability. In 2010, he received a congressional appointment to the National Advisory Committee on Institutional Quality and Integrity. And in 2011, he was appointed co-chair of the Iowa Science, Technology, Engineering, and Mathematics Advisory Council.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Regents, State of Iowa, as President of Iowa State University, it gives me great pleasure to bestow upon you, Dr. Benjamin J. Allen, the honorary degree, Doctor of Humane Letters, with all attendant rights, privileges, and obligations.
Dr. Benjamin Allen will now present the commencement address.
President Geoffroy, Provost Hoffman, faculty, staff, parents, most importantly, my fellow degree recipients, good afternoon. Before I get into my very brief comments, I want to talk about one of my items in my bucket list. One was to get from that side of the stage to this side of the stage. It took me 7 years to do it, so I feel very good about that accomplishment also. Thank you, President Geoffroy and Iowa State community, for this extraordinary honor. Receiving an honorary degree from such an outstanding university, and one that is very special to me, was quite honestly unexpected, but much appreciated. During my 25 years here, I learned much from and enjoyed working with the students and faculty and fellow administrators and staff of this great university. My wife, Pat, and daughter, Jessica, who shared those ISU experiences, are here today, along with Jessica's husband and their three kids that we now call our three grandkids. To share this moment with my family and so many of my friends from Iowa State University and a special doctoral candidate from you and I is priceless. This university has long been recognized as a great institution, but under the leadership of President Geoffroy, Iowa State University has become more vibrant, more relevant, and even more respected. I have personally benefited from working for and with President Geoffroy, but more importantly, this university and the state of Iowa have benefited greatly from his leadership. So I take great pride in receiving this honorary degree from Iowa State University and thank all involved in making it happen. But I know today is not about me, it's about all of you out there. And I want to start by saying congratulations to each of you. We have bachelor candidates, master's candidates, and doctoral candidates. President Geoffroy asked me to give a commencement speech. So I've been thinking and thinking about what kind of wise advice I could give you today. So, like most of you, I Googled commencement speeches. I found a list of the 25 best commencement speeches, and I have to tell you that there are some really fantastic, beautifully written ones by people like Bishop Tutu, Steve Jobs, Barbara Kingsolver, and the Dalai Lama. I'm afraid this afternoon's speech is not going to make that list. So go ahead, especially if you partied late last night, let your eyes glaze over, but promise me, after celebrating is over, Google that list and read a couple of those. They're outstanding. But I want to share just one issue with you that has been helpful to me in achieving some degree of success. In December, 44 years ago, 1967, a movie called The Graduate, starring a very young Dustin Hoffman. For those who are too young, he's won a couple Oscars since then. He played the role of a young man who just graduated from college. In the movie, a wise older man at the reception in honor of the recent graduate leans over and whispers into Hoffman's ear and says, "This is the key to success now that you graduated from college." And that word was plastic, plastics. That word at this time might be like whispering biorenewables. But if I were to whisper one word in your ear today, a key to your success, a word with more staying power than plastic, and that has a long staying power, and that would be listen. Listening means, first of all, heeding those voices that you knowingly or unknowingly listened to in your earlier years and during your time here at Iowa State University. It means expanding that listening to those around you as you go out in the world in order to be the best scientist, best teacher, best engineer, business person, architect, ag specialist, or whatever you've been studying here for the last 4 or 5 years. I'd like to share a brief personal note on those early years of listening and the impact it had on me. I listened, maybe without realizing it, at the time to three men who were and remained important in my life. And about 15 years ago, I wrote letters back to two of those men, thanking them for the impact they had. The one had already passed away. One was a grade school teacher, coach, principal, Raymond Giroud. And Principal Giroud encouraged me to reach higher, to set loftier goals. And for whatever reason, and there were some reasons, at that time, I did not have much confidence. So I took his words to heart. Unfortunately, despite his pep talk and his very convincing words, I never became that NBA basketball player. But I did set loftier goals in the academic area, and that has served me very, very well. And then there was a gentle giant of a farmer, Maynard Smith, who told me that humor and laughter are the keys to a successful life. You'll find this out, everyone has the key to a successful life. He taught me that while you must have confidence in your abilities and take your work seriously, at the same time, you can't take yourself too seriously. And in the various positions I've held at Iowa State University and now president at UNI, I have dealt with some obviously serious issues. And while I took those issues seriously, I also tried to use humor, when appropriate, to soften the tension, to reduce the tension, to get a solution. And then the final reference here is in graduate school, there was a very special professor, Dr. John Dew, my PhD advisor. And many of you could identify with some faculty member here at Iowa State University. Dr. Dew, who told me at the pinnacle of my studies, just receiving my doctoral degree, he said, "You know, Ben, there'll be always people smarter than you." And that set me back a little bit at that time, but that advice has kept me somewhat humble, but more importantly, it has reminded me that throughout my professional life is to learn from others around me. And I'm sure that you could name your own Principal Giroud's, Maynard Smith's, or Dr. Dew's. Many of those men and women are in the audience here today. Perhaps your parents, your grandparents, your spouses, partners, and they share much of the responsibility for your success. All right, you might argue, I've listened to those people, I've been listening to my professors for the undergraduates for 4 or 5, whatever program you're on, and for the graduate students even longer. And now I'm ready to get out there and speak and do, to make decisions. You know all there is to know now. Heaven knows you've written it all down on exams and in research papers and master's thesis and doctoral dissertations. And you're now ready to go out and begin imparting the knowledge and wisdom on a world which I admit is very much in need of sage advice and guidance. So enough with the listening, let's go on with the talking and doing. But I give you the words of that old wise philosopher, TV personality Larry King, who said, quote, "I remind myself every morning, nothing I say this day will teach me anything. So if I'm going to learn, I must do it by listening." So if you're wise and you really want to be successful, I suggest that listening will never stop. As noted by Oliver Wendell Holmes, who wrote, "Is the province of knowledge to speak, is the privilege of wisdom to listen." The most important part of my job as president of the University of Northern Iowa is to listen and to understand before making a decision. I listen to students, to staff, to alums, to regents, to parents, to politicians, and yes, even to faculty, although sometimes they deny that. In reflecting upon all the issues and problems that I have been asked to resolve as president at UNI, and my various positions here referenced earlier, it is clear to me that the quality of my decisions is highly correlated with the time and effort I made to carefully listen to all the parties involved in the issue. It is not correlated at all to the amount of time I talk. I learned that to listen to people, really to listen to people, takes time, effort, practice, and even courage. As Winston Churchill stated, quote, "Courage is what it takes to stand up and speak, but courage is also what it takes to sit down and listen." When I'm in the process of making difficult decisions, I think of the three men I listened to earlier in my life. I listen to the voice of Principal Giroud that gives me the confidence to handle the problem. I listen to the voice of Maynard Smith and tell myself that the world is not going to stop spinning by this decision. And I listen to the voice of Dr. Dew telling me to seek the advice of those wiser and smarter than I am. And I do that. and for the past 10 years, that has often meant seeking the advice and listening to President Geoffroy. But I also know that at the end of the process, I will make a decision and speak. And by taking listening seriously, I have more confidence that my decision will be the right decision. And sometimes, make that most of the time, you simply cannot resolve an issue satisfactory for everyone. But I can say from experience that often what people want is simply to know that they have been listened to, seriously listened to. It is a simple idea, that is a simple message that I'm presenting to you today, but don't let the simplicity define the importance of the message. Listening is a skill. You must practice it. You have to learn to listen with an open mind, with a willingness to understand and respect opposing views, rather than only a readiness for rebuttal. As noted by Stephen Covey in his book, The Seven Habits of Highly Effective People, first seek to understand, then to be understood. In closing, let me leave you with very specific career advice from everyone's favorite president, Calvin Coolidge. He said, quote, "No man ever listened himself out of a job." So go forth, graduates, and listen to the world. Sift through all the noise and listen closely to the voices around you. Seek out those smarter and wiser and listen. So this afternoon at your post-commencement parties, be alert for someone who might whisper in your ear that one word that might be so important for your success. Thank you, President Geoffroy, Provost Hoffman, and Iowa State University for these two great honors. First, the honorary degree, which I do cherish, but also the privilege of addressing my fellow degree recipients from Iowa State University. Congratulations to all.
Thank you, Dr. Allen. We are indeed honored to have you with us here today and to present you with the honorary Doctorate of Humane Letters degree. And we thank you for your many contributions to education, to our society, and for your very special friendship. We will now hear from our student brass ensemble under the direction of Dr. Michael Galimo.
President Gregory Geoffroy will now recognize students graduating with distinction and then confer degrees to the graduates.
At this time, I call upon Dr. Elizabeth Hoffman, Executive Vice President and Provost, for recognizing students graduating with distinction and honors.
I would like to recognize at this time the graduate students who are receiving Teaching Excellence Awards and Research Excellence Awards. Those receiving Teaching Excellence Awards and Research Excellence Awards are being recognized for outstanding teaching and for research accomplishments in a graduate program, and they are wearing cardinal and gold honor cords. Will those students please rise? We congratulate all of you. Please be seated. And now I would like to recognize the undergraduates who are graduating with distinction. Grade point averages are based on a 4.0 scale. In addition to the notation in the commencement program, this recognition appears on the official transcript and diploma. Those graduating summa cum laude with the highest distinction have earned a grade point average of 3.90 or higher and are wearing cardinal and gold honor cords. Will those graduates of highest distinction please rise and be recognized? Students graduating magna cum laude with great distinction have a grade point average of 3.70 to 3.89 and are wearing gold honor cords. Will those students please rise? Students graduating cum laude with distinction have a grade point average of 3.50 to 3.69 and are wearing cardinal honor cords. Will those students please rise? Please be seated. And now I would like to recognize the undergraduates who are graduating from the University Honors Program. These students have maintained a cumulative grade point average of at least 3.35 and have shown initiative in developing their own individualized programs of study and ingenuity in designing and completing an independent honors research project. Those students are wearing white cords, and many of them are also wearing cardinal and gold or cardinal or gold cords. So would those students please rise as well? Congratulations to all the graduates who are graduating with distinction or with teaching or research awards. We will now proceed with the conferring of graduate degrees. Some degrees will be conferred in absentia. The Dean of the Graduate College will ask the candidates to stand and will present them to the President. After the President formally awards the degrees, the graduates will be seated. A faculty marshal will dismiss students to come to the stage to be recognized. We will begin with the conferring of the Doctor of Philosophy degrees, the highest degree that Iowa State University confers. And I would like to say a few words about the history of academic attire and the special nature of the hooding ceremony. Academic gowns have been part of the university experience since the 12th century and the advent of the first European universities. Because these early schools were connected to great cathedrals like those at Bologna and Chartres, the black gown of the schoolmasters or scholastics emulated the sober dignity of the clergy and signified a life dedicated to learning. In addition, the ample materials of the gown served to keep the scholars warm in the drafty rooms in the medieval times. Hoods were also functional, like the hood on a monk's habit, while colors were reserved for masters or teachers rather than bachelors or students. Initially, the colors indicated one's discipline, such as the green of nature for a degree in medicine. Mortarboards with black or gold tassels and school colors came later, but the clerical formality of the academic gown continues to represent the dedication and nobility of the scholar's vocation. During the hooding ceremony, the degree recipients will be escorted and hooded by their major professors who have worked with them throughout their study for the doctoral degree. The hoods will connect the graduate with a family of scholars throughout history and all around the world and with this university. The Dean of the Graduate College, Dr. David Holger, will present the candidates for the degree, Doctor of Philosophy, from the Graduate College.
The candidates for the degree, Doctor of Philosophy, will please rise. The Doctor of Philosophy is the university's highest academic degree, awarded only to those who have successfully completed an intensive and demanding course of study, whose primary focus is on learning to conduct original research. The final stage of the program is the preparation and defense of a dissertation that describes the outcome of a major research project. To prepare for that project, the student must have gained expertise and skills in a particular discipline and must have thoroughly explored its existing knowledge base. Those who receive doctorates today have, therefore, demonstrated that they are truly experts in their fields whose research has already contributed significantly to human knowledge. The hood they assume symbolizes their admission to the exclusive ranks of those who have earned the respect associated with the title Doctor of Philosophy. President Geoffroy, these candidates have completed all required courses, have demonstrated their ability in research, and have passed all examinations. They are recommended by the graduate faculty and the faculty senate, and are approved by the Board of Regents, State of Iowa, for the degree Doctor of Philosophy.
In recognition of the satisfactory completion of your respective programs in the Graduate College, by the authority delegated to me by the State of Iowa, I confer upon you the degree Doctor of Philosophy, with its accompanying rights, privileges, and obligations. The diploma, now to be placed in your hands, and the hood with which you will be invested, shall forever be the testimony of your high academic rank.
Daniel Wright Adrian, major in statistics, presented by Dr. Nettleton. Hiri Afese Engwa, major in toxicology, presented by Dr. Kanthasamy. Hisham Mohammed Amasaid, major in computer engineering, presented by Dr. Mina. Arun Kumar Aisaitambi, major in toxicology, presented by Dr. Kanthasamy. Preeti Baze, major in bioinformatics and computational biology, presented by Dr. Dickerson. Prasanna Balachandran, major in materials science and engineering, presented by Dr. Rajan. Sean Thomas Bayouth, major in industrial and agricultural technology, presented by Dr. Karen. Joel Bolkin, Major in Education, presented by Dr. Lannan. Brenda Caroline Businski, Major in Education, presented by Dr. Lannan. Min Chai, Major in Condensed Matter Physics, presented by Dr. Shinar. Weili Chai, Major in Molecular, Cellular, and Developmental Biology, presented by Dr. Johansson. Alexis Ann Campbell, Major in Plant Biology, presented by Dr. Yando Nelson. Christina Marie Carpenter, Major in Education, presented by Dr. Evers. Brenda Carrillo Conde, Major in Chemical Engineering, presented by Dr. Narasimhan. Keating Chen, Major in Horticulture, presented by Dr. Aurora. Shuangwen Chen, Major in Mechanical Engineering, presented by Dr. Heindel. Ying Chen, Major in Condensed Matter Physics, presented by Dr. Shinar. Laura Christensen, Co-Major in Agricultural Engineering and Sustainable Agriculture, presented by Dr. Helmers. Kara Jost Dinas, Major in Industrial Engineering, presented by Dr. Jackman. Joshua Byron Drake, Major in Mechanical Engineering, presented by Dr. Heindel. James Dunn, Major in Inorganic Chemistry, presented by Dr. Sadow. Albert Devin Farr, Major in Education, presented by Dr. Evers. Ryan Michael Gerdes, Major in Electrical Engineering, presented by Dr. Mina. David Stephen Gogarty, Major in Biochemistry, presented by Dr. Bobic. Karen Elaine Grote, Major in Plant Breeding, presented by Dr. Lee. Kelly Marie Harburg, Major in Immunobiology, presented by Dr. Wanamuller. Kevin Frank Howe, Major in Agricultural History and Rural Studies, presented by Dr. Reine Kerberg. Wei Hu, major in materials science and engineering, presented by Dr. Tan. Xiaopeng Wang, major in mechanical engineering, presented by Dr. Heindel. Hilary Nicole Eisbrands, major in civil engineering, presented by Dr. Van Leeuwen. Na Jin, major in economics, presented by Dr. Lentz. Boris Jovanovich, co-major in toxicology and fisheries biology, presented by Dr. Palik and Dr. Pierce. Joo-hee Kang, major in hospitality management, presented by Dr. Fiore. Chung Jun Kim, major in materials science and engineering, presented by Dr. Russell. Sung Ha Kim, major in chemical engineering, presented by Dr. Lam. Keith Edward King, major in genetics, presented by Dr. Shoemaker. Eric Richard Klubakowski, major in inorganic chemistry, presented by Dr. Wu. Yelena Kraft, major in biochemistry, presented by Dr. Miller. Stephanie Ann Krauth, major in education, presented by Dr. Ebers. Barbara Krieg, major in education, presented by Dr. Ebers. Brenda Lee Krogh-Durie, major in education, presented by Dr. Lannan. Nicholas Bradley Larson, co-major in statistics and bioinformatics and computational biology, presented by Dr. Nettleton. Sarum Sok Leong, major in physical chemistry, presented by Dr. Gordon. Sumudu Pamoda Leilananda, major in bioinformatics, presented by Dr. Jernigan. Shijong Lee, major in electrical engineering, presented by Dr. Ramamurti. Christopher Lineberry, major in mechanical engineering, presented by Dr. Brem Stetcher. Lin Liu, major in mechanical engineering, presented by Dr. Kim. Sijia Liu, major in applied mathematics, presented by Dr. Matsavinos. Rafael Lopez Quirino, major in chemistry, presented by Dr. Kessler. John Dustin Loy, major in veterinary microbiology, presented by Dr. Harris. Wei Lu, major in electrical engineering, presented by Dr. Vaswani. Kathleen Ann Malone, major in sociology, presented by Dr. Stewart. Yelena Medic, major in food science and technology, presented by Dr. Jane. Debjani Mitra, co-major in biorenewable resources and technology and food science and technology, presented by Dr. Brem Stetcher and Dr. Van Leeuwen. Mark Andrew Newell, major in plant breeding, presented by Dr. Beavis. Jonathan David Oliver, major in entomology, presented by Dr. Bartholomew. Agustin Pagani, major in soil science, presented by Dr. Malarino. Brian James Patterson, major in computer science, presented by Dr. Lathrop and Dr. Lutz. Gregory Allen Pfeiffer, major in genetics, presented by Dr. Shoemaker. Daniel Keith Pratt, major in condensed matter physics, presented by Dr. McQueenie. Tsengek Perujav, major in animal science, presented by Dr. Hoffman. Chongyan Chen, major in materials science and engineering, presented by Dr. Anderson. Nevan Kakkun Ramalingam, major in electrical engineering, presented by Dr. Wang. Joel Rodney Reakin, major in materials science and engineering, presented by Dr. Anderson. Sean Joseph Riley, major in organic chemistry, presented by Dr. Hulk. Kathy Marie Rogatsky, major in education, presented by Dr. Lannan. Andrew Joseph Ryder, major in education, presented by Dr. Hagedorn. Michelle Schmidt, major in education, presented by Dr. Ebers. Bethany Joyce Guttinger, major in education, presented by Dr. Ebers. Il Chung Shin, major in biochemistry, presented by Dr. Nielsen Hamilton. Adam Joe Shuttleworth, major in mechanical engineering, presented by Dr. Kelkar. Scott Walter Smalley, major in agricultural education and studies, presented by Dr. Ritalik. Tyler Nicholas Sundag, major in computer science, presented by Dr. Rajan. Gaurishankar Srinivasan, major in biorenewable resources and technology, presented by Dr. Gruel. Sonia Eva Marie Stutzman, major in human development and family studies, presented by Dr. Murphy. Hakan Topakaya, major in electrical engineering, presented by Dr. Wang. Ryan Lee Vanderveen, major in immunobiology, presented by Dr. Harris. Jennifer Amy Vogel, major in ecology and evolutionary biology, presented by Dr. Coford. Fei Wong, major in inorganic chemistry, presented by Dr. Miller. Kimberly Whirling Johnson, major in education, presented by Dr. Evers. Christiana Wiebeck, major in plant breeding, presented by Dr. Graham. Travis Michael Witte, major in analytical chemistry, presented by Dr. Hulk. Rachel Marie Wolford, major in rhetoric and professional communication, presented by Dr. Roberts. Yufang Wu, major in mechanical engineering, presented by Dr. Kim. Ying Sha, major in chemistry, presented by Dr. Kessler. Yanan Yue, major in mechanical engineering, presented by Dr. Heindel. Wei Zhong, major in computer science, presented by Dr. Wong. Yengjie Zhong, major in chemical engineering, presented by Dr. Clapp. Pingshu Zhong, major in statistics, presented by Dr. Nettleton. Wei Lin Chu, major in biochemistry, presented by Dr. Bobek. Mandy K. Zimmerly, major in biochemistry, presented by Dr. Debabatai. Michael Thomas Zimmerman, major in bioinformatics and computational biology, presented by Dr. Jernigan.
My congratulations to all our doctoral graduates. We take great pride in your educational achievements, doctors. The candidates for the master's degree will please rise. The master's degree is awarded to those who have successfully completed an intensive course of study in a particular discipline. Reflecting the diversity of ways in which advanced knowledge and skills can be obtained, the university awards a variety of master's degrees with specific names and expectations. In many fields, a master's degree represents the highest academic achievement, and degree holders are accorded full recognition as practitioners of its art. The master's degree often involves research and the preparation of a thesis or creative component that demonstrates an ability to conduct original inquiry. All of those who receive their degrees today have demonstrated a dedication to learning and to enhancing their abilities to contribute to society. Their degrees demonstrate that they have truly mastered a complex and demanding body of knowledge. President Geoffroy, these candidates have completed the requirements prescribed by their respective degree programs. They are recommended by the Graduate Faculty and Faculty Senate and are approved by the Board of Regents, State of Iowa, for their master's degrees.
In recognition of the satisfactory completion of your respective programs in the Graduate College, by the authority delegated to me by the State of Iowa, I confer upon you the master's degree with its accompanying rights, privileges, and obligations. The diploma, now to be placed in your hands, shall forever be the testimony of this academic achievement.
Sai Shiri Tesha Menidu, Master of Science in Computer Engineering and Information Assurance.
Geoffroy Allen Butcher, Master of Science in Mechanical Engineering.
Gianni Fadoi Barachisto.
Richard
Master of Science in Engineering Mechanics.
Richard Wade Montgomery III, Master of Education.
Avinash Tinivasa, Master of Science in Computer Engineering.
Jared Andrew Klein, Master of Science in Electrical Engineering.
Suhas Shetty, Master of Science in Computer Engineering.
Chad William Hill, Master of Science in Agronomy.
Elizabeth Ann Childs, Master of Science in Agricultural Education.
Kathleen Marie Bronner, Master of Engineering in Systems Engineering.
Kevin Richard Duerfeld, Master of Science in Horticulture.
Joseph Michael Capesius, Master of Education.
Virtus C. Albright III, Master of Science in Toxicology.
Jose A. Perez Reboredo, Master of Science in Civil Engineering.
Christopher Patrick Watts, Master of Science in Industrial Engineering.
Stephen Michael Lavrenz, Master of Science in Civil Engineering.
Carla Marie Grayson, Master of Science in Agronomy.
Ariane Dominique Ross, Master of Science in Mathematics.
Jan Denise Burke, Master of Family and Consumer Sciences.
Paul Daniel Hertz, Master of Science in Mathematics.
Volodymyr V. Sukov, Master of Science in Applied Mathematics.
Ezenwani Ifioma Lananya, Master of Education.
Nicholas M. Sherman, Master of Arts in History.
Anicia Nicola Peters, Master of Science in Human-Computer Interaction.
Cole Adam Boatwright, Master of Education.
Jolene Nicole Liebel, Master of Education.
Donna E. Kiesling, Master of Education.
Kaylin J. Hensel, Master of Education.
Beverly Lynn Jenkinson, Master of Education.
Jeffrey T. Alfred, Master of Science in Entomology.
Mark Timothy Scholes, Master of Education.
Carlos Antonio Gazmuri, Master of Science in Seed Technology and Business.
Brian Brunel Walker, Master of Architecture.
Kevin Joseph Condon, Master of Public Administration.
Lori Ann Walker, Master of Science in Food Science and Technology.
Leonardo Aguilera, Master of Science in Information Assurance.
Nancy Lynn Girard, Master of Arts in Interdisciplinary Graduate Studies.
Yi Zhou, Master of Science, Apparel Educational Studies and Hospitality Management.
William Allen Hunt, Master of Arts in History.
Joanne Kosher Simpson, Master of Science in Interdisciplinary Graduate Studies.
Barbara Ellen Jennings, Master of Education.
Theodore P. Gunther, Master of Science in Crop Production and Physiology.
Anne A. Rubenbauer, Master of Education.
Barris Evren, Master of Public Administration.
Jeremy Michael Case, Master of Science in Civil Engineering.
Kanchan Guntupalli, Master of Science in Aerospace Engineering.
Patrick Lee Buckwalter, Master of Science in Agronomy.
Brett Allen Pfeffer, Master of Engineering in Systems Engineering.
Jennifer Marie Kelling, Master of Education.
Diane Louise Flannery, Master of Education.
Vanessa May Kavam, Master of Science in Statistics.
Lee Ju, Master of Science in Journalism and Mass Communication.
Dolly Marie Dillon, Master of Education.
Yue Zhao, Master of Science in Computer Engineering.
Carol Ann Ryerson, Master of Education.
Barbara Ann Gerlach, Master of Arts in Arts and Design.
Michelle Renee DeHart, Master of Education.
Karen E. Bittner, Master of Science in Psychology.
Matthew Thomas Manson, Master of Education.
Humberto Fuentes Sanz, Master of Science in Industrial Engineering.
Michelle Lynn Cook, Master of Public Administration.
Shane Michael Rowenfons, Master of Education.
Kathleen Renee Tapper, Master of Science in Biomedical Sciences.
Lyle Irvin Whitmer, Master of Science in Mechanical Engineering and Biorenewable Resources and Technology.
Sarah Elizabeth Atwood, Master of Science in Genetics.
Chanda Mumba Mwanza, Master of Family and Consumer Sciences.
Wei Fong, Master of Science in Biochemistry.
Meheravani Boha, Master of Science in Interdisciplinary Graduate Studies.
Catherine A. Paulson, Master of Science in Kinesiology.
Craig Allen Kremen, Master of Engineering in Civil Engineering.
Douglas Robert Hartwell, Master of Science in Civil Engineering.
Robert A. Wims, Master of Engineering in Mechanical Engineering.
Swarna Kumar Padmanambhuni, Master of Engineering in Civil Engineering.
Pradeep Surya Narayanan, Master of Science in Food Science and Technology.
Nathan Robert Charles Bester, Master of Science in Plant Pathology.
Michael R. Shimkus, Master of Science in Civil Engineering.
Nicholas A. Lowen, Master of Public Administration.
Lindsay R. Ritchie, Master of Science in Education.
George Thomas McGuire, Master of Public Administration.
Daniel Timothy Reinhardt, Master of Agriculture and Professional Agriculture.
Marcelo Mawuko Edo, Master of Engineering in Systems Engineering.
Brandon Jeriel McMillan, Master of Engineering in Mechanical Engineering.
Kuan Yu Chen, Master of Science in Computer Engineering.
Carol King Stock, Master of Family and Consumer Sciences in Human Development and Family Studies.
Jeffrey Tyler Von Braun, Master of Science in Transportation.
Rachel Dabney Peacher, Master of Science in Sustainable Agriculture.
Mitchell D. Klein, Master of Science in Geology.
Amar Abdulghani Melabari, Master of Science in Mechanical Engineering.
Peter Jacob Becker, Master of Science in Civil Engineering.
Lin Shen, Master of Business Administration.
Sonia Chug, Master of Science in Education.
Teng Wang, Master of Science in Civil Engineering.
Tassara Aline Ocheski, Master of Education.
Ritu Munde, Master of Science in Computer Science.
Curtis Michael Powers, Master of Public Administration.
Homan Tang, Master of Science in Plant Biology.
Abayomi Abiodun Abatan, Master of Science in Meteorology.
Andrew Douglas Steinmetz, Master of Science in Material Science and Engineering.
Sayanti Mukhopadhyay, Master of Science in Civil Engineering.
Brandy Marie Jacobs, Master of Science in Animal Science.
Cheng Peng, Master of Public Administration.
Chao Wang, Master of Accounting.
Rachel A. Voss, Master of Arts in Political Science.
Tong Wang, Master of Engineering in Civil Engineering.
Sweta Vangavetti, Master of Science in Bioinformatics and Computational Biology.
Chun Dong, Master of Engineering in Mechanical Engineering.
Ahmed Hosni Abdelzabor, Master of Engineering in Mechanical Engineering.
Chase J. Prapua, Master of Architecture.
Allison J. Severson, Master of Science in Education.
Ying Shu Brown, Master of Engineering in Mechanical Engineering.
Devin K. Dutley, Master of Science in Food Science and Technology.
Yuan Feng, Master of Engineering in Industrial Engineering.
Congratulations to all those receiving master's degrees today.
We shall now proceed to the award conferring of undergraduate degrees and the awarding of diplomas. Will all the candidates for the bachelor's degrees please rise? President Geoffroy, these candidates have satisfactorily completed their prescribed curricula in their respective colleges. They have been recommended by the college faculty and the faculty senate and are approved by the Board of Regents, State of Iowa, for the bachelor's degree.
In recognition of the satisfactory completion of your studies in your respective colleges, and by the authority granted to me by the Board of Regents, State of Iowa, I confer upon you your bachelor's degree. And as is tradition, I ask that all bachelor's degree recipients move their tassels from the right side to the left side of your cap. Congratulations.
Candidates from each college will walk to the side stairs, up the platform, and across the stage to be recognized. We will begin with the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences. Dean Wendy Winterstein will present the college's student marshal to President Geoffroy.
President Geoffroy, Provost Hoffman, it is my privilege to present to you the student marshal from the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences, Barton Howard. He is escorted by Dr. Richard Schultz, Professor of Natural Resource Ecology and Management. Bart is graduating magna cum laude with degrees in forestry and agricultural business. He was a letter winner on the track team and was selected to represent the student chapter of the Society of American Foresters at its national convention this fall. But he is most proud of his family. How his parents, William and Rose Howard, and his mother, Christine Souter, raised him, and how close he is with his two sisters. Bart and his sisters, Hannah and Holly, were ISU students together, all majoring in natural resource fields. Bart will be working as an arborist for Ryan Lawn and Tree in Kansas City. Please join me in congratulating Bart.
Carl Jacob Moritz.
Mary Ann Alvarez.
Kylie Robert Swanson.
Travis Allen Graves.
Alan Donald Royster.
Deanna L. Orr.
Patrick Grady McGregor.
Shane Michael Bingham.
Stephen Troy Bowers.
Jack Andrew Roach.
Daniel Ray Vandermeulen.
Kyle Stephen Plum.
Michael Lee Warmley.
Jeffrey Michael Torreson.
Daniel Dean Poduska.
Michael G. Zeiger.
Sarah Gomat.
Danielle Sue Axline.
Sarah Christine Parr.
Erica K. Schnettler.
Raymond Michael Tharp.
Christine Marie Harms.
Timothy Van Buffington.
Malika Buttermug.
Jeffrey Daniel Hulk.
Rachel Amory Kreese.
Justin Roy Sines.
Hiwat Abibi.
Jocelyn D. Ferguson.
Bethany Ruth Drury.
Logan Lee Ferguson.
Kyle Hubbard Degener.
Brendan Michael Gross.
Calvin R. Navarro.
Komlan Senam Avichino.
Drew Allen Leitz.
Braden Christopher Boydston.
Jeff Daniel Visser.
Kyle T. Corkery.
Darian Orias Taramana.
Luke Marcus Schlitzer.
Kenneth Jean McCabe.
John M. J.
Mitchell Lewis Menke.
Linnea Rebecca Saylor.
Brittany Jean Heim.
Michaela Spring.
Carly Ann Cummings.
Tyler John Alexander. Cameron Harwood Ludke.
Jacqueline Denise Collins. Samantha Teresa Wozni.
I would like to congratulate the graduates from the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences. The faculty members in our college take great pride in your achievements and join me in wishing you the very best upon graduation. Stay in touch.
And now, graduates from the College of Business. Dean Labhira will present the college's student marshal to President Geoffroy.
President Geoffroy and Provost Hoffman, the College of Business student marshal today is Jacob Talbot. He's escorted by his favorite instructor, Kayla Christensen, lecturer in accounting. Jacob is graduating with a Bachelor of Science in Management with a grade point of 3.92 and is in the top 2% of his graduating class. Throughout his time at Iowa State, Jacob has balanced his studies with an array of student organization activities. He's a member of the ISU Alumni Association, Beta Gamma Sigma International Honor Society, and was the president of Delta Sigma Pi Business Fraternity. Jacob attributes his academic success to support of his family and friends and the high expectations to his professors held him accountable throughout his adventure at Iowa State. Congratulations, Jacob.
Trevor Lee Kilstrom.
Clinton John Lehman Curry.
Christina M. Vilches.
Ryan Lee Renshaw.
Shane Robert Manful.
Jesse Robert Gieske.
Tyler John Hendricks.
Eric Andrew Hall.
Brittany Leanne Sweeney.
Wai Dung.
Gretchen K. Vogel.
Yi Liu.
Meredith Gail Young.
Brittany Sue Cruz.
Jacob Lee Johnson.
Min Quach Kai Pham.
Kathleen Ann Kettering.
Kyle Allen Hoey.
Justin David Holm.
Melissa Ann Redding.
Ashvin Sudaharan.
Chung Heng Lim.
Hilal Muhammad Al Tahili.
Benjamin David Dobbs.
Ji Ting Nu.
Michael James Barker.
William Baron Soriadi.
Amanda Jean McWhirter.
Trium Duong.
James Gilbert McLaughlin.
Sui Yen Lim.
Jason Matthew Williams.
Xin Shi.
Yao Fu.
Wenting Chi.
Mira Son.
Barinda Satija.
Wenhua Ding.
Su Tu.
Wei Chi Chao.
Xiang Diao.
Whitney Rachel Lenz.
Joe Limo Kazgi.
Dion LaShawn Sims.
Shehua Shu.
Herbert Zimba Zailu.
Yujie Huang.
Osamayor Omokeli Abalu,
Katie Ann Kozer,
Jared John Tony,
Matthew D. Prane,
Nicholas Donald Thompson,
Laura Elizabeth Rieger, Mengdual Yang, Mason A. Wells, David Robert Heinegger, Haohai Shui,
on behalf of the College of Business faculty, staff, and students, congratulations to our newest graduates and best wishes.
And now the College of Design. Dean Luis Rico Gutierrez will present the college's student marshal to President Geoffroy.
Dr. Geoffroy, Provost Hoffman, it is my privilege to present to you the student marshal from the College of Design, Paola Sepúlveda. She is escorted today by Carl Rogers, Associate Professor of Landscape Architecture. Paola chose Associate Professor Carl Rogers as her faculty escort today because he helped her gain her bearings during her first year in the Landscape Architecture program and challenged her to push further in her work. Paola Sepúlveda is graduating magna cum laude with a Bachelor of Landscape Architecture degree. She is also near completion of her Master of Landscape Architecture degree. While at Iowa State University, Paola has served as a teaching and research assistant for several faculty members in Landscape Architecture and the College of Design's Core Design program. She represented Landscape Architecture as a graduate and professional student senator for 2 years, and is especially proud of founding APTERIX, the new Landscape Architecture Graduate Student Organization. In 2010, Paola received a $2,500 Barbara King Landscape Architecture Scholarship for Innovation and Entrepreneurship for her project relating to guerrilla cinema and revitalization of public space, which became her master's thesis project. Paola would like to work as an urban designer to create successful public spaces that help to invigorate life in our cities. Congratulations.
Colin Matthew Robin.
Leslie Day.
Wei Chi Chu.
Xiaoyun Mao.
Chi Chan.
Jason Michael Knox.
Michelle Yvonne Heidel.
Caitlin Ashley DeVolbus.
Tomas M. Aguilar.
Tyler Scott Custer.
Natasha Lynn Randolph.
Paul R. Klippel.
Mariah Jade Marquis.
Carolyn Loretta Zundell.
Zachary John Copriva.
Sydney Michelle Patero.
Scott Randall Huffman.
Rusha Kishora Agnihotri.
Nathan Wesley Pontier.
Bethany Joy Johnson.
Kelly Christine Nelson.
Graduates, on behalf of the College of Design faculty, staff, and students, I offer sincere congratulations and best wishes for all that the future may hold for you.
And now the College of Engineering. Dean Jonathan Wickard will present the college's student marshal to President Geoffroy.
President Geoffroy and Provost Hoffman, it is my privilege to present to you Kyle DeBalek, student marshal from the College of Engineering. He is escorted today by Dr. Steve Martin, distinguished professor of materials science and engineering. Kyle, whose hometown is Minneapolis, is graduating today with majors in both materials science and engineering and German, and with high honors. In his career at Iowa State, Kyle ventured far beyond our campus. He studied abroad at the Mannheim University of Applied Sciences in Germany. He also completed two overseas research experiences in universities in Hanover and Münster. Kyle's honors project, a collaborative effort with Dr. Martin and his colleagues in Münster, used nuclear magnetic resonance to observe how structural elements in glasses vary according to their composition. Kyle will attend graduate school in Germany next fall, where he will continue his studies in materials engineering. Kyle, you are an exceptional student and a global citizen, and we extend our heartfelt congratulations to you.
William Randolph Emerson.
Jared Michael Kral.
Saleh Muhammad Alawood.
David Lee Christensen.
Daniel James Mattson.
Andre Alexander Youngerman.
Jacob Daniel Karish.
Robert Donald Eschbach.
Jessica Lee Jacobs.
Michael Darrell Marshall.
So Fong Chang.
Theodore David Bechtum.
Jared Francis Ross.
Paul Anthony Ledge.
John Edward Simons.
Nathan Stephen Willey.
Alan John Casson.
Wade Maurice Sitzman.
Kristen Ann Lipschultz.
Christine Helen Gleason.
Nathan Lewis Lentz.
Patrick Terry Gent.
Lacey Marie Kroll.
Jeremy Paul Ellsburn.
Sean Michael Leeper.
Chris Lawrence von Jarsveld.
David Richard Fleeler.
Augustine John Palumbo.
Nathan Donald Meisgeier.
Brendan Alexander Babcock.
Jared Adrian Kuhl.
Aileen Ann Vandermeid.
Colin Michael Schroeder.
Vishal Deepak Bakshi.
Scott Jeffrey Simmons.
William Douglas Schmidt.
Joseph Daniel Verks.
Saif Khalid Al-Tali.
Almir Melkic.
Michael Stephen Hahn.
Alexander John McBride.
Alexandra Geraldine Bruns.
Christopher Martin Faber.
Sarah Lynn Mestad.
Luke Douglas Applegate.
Joshua Arnold Werner.
Matthew Dale Miller.
Andrew Robert Kilpo.
Michael Daniel Gherkin.
Zachary Allen Bonzer.
Nicholas William Dupre.
Jordan Paul Denman.
Brian Joseph McDonald.
Victor E. Villagomez. Prokulp Sudhakar.
James Nathan Mueller.
Blake William McLaughlin.
James Daniel Weisler.
Michael Philip Eldridge.
Kyle Richard Dickinson.
Ethan Jared Morgan.
Austin Scott McCann.
Tyler John Lagi.
Dusty Joseph Gutzman.
Daniel Lee Saddam. Richard Edward Hanton.
Roshni K. Patel.
James Dwayne Cleveland.
Nathan Gull Leaners.
Christopher Paul DeGroot.
Stephanie Lynn Schwalbe.
Hubert G.
Travis Levi Almond.
Trent Michael Ray.
Joanna Ray Wabina.
Tanner Allen Voss.
Devendra Jayasingham.
Jordan Joseph Ruby.
Benjamin L. Adams.
Stephen Douglas Wetherell.
William Scott Marshall.
Nicholas Dwayne Granfield.
Luke Larry Leibovich.
Jonathan Robert Leonard.
Logan William Pals.
Brandon Irwin Mogensen.
Joseph P. Grady.
Ryan Jonathan Hurst.
Jeffrey Allen Kramer.
Rachel Emily Franz.
Mot Tariq Azmi.
Derek Michael Joseph.
Spencer Davis Mussman.
Anna Claire Potter.
Bradley Jean Sickles.
Nicholas Tyler Martinez.
Jacob Brian George.
Arda Kolak.
Jason Thomas Rushoff.
Andrew Charles Vogie.
Benjamin Alexander Britz.
Matthew B. Magnifico.
Tanner David Munson.
Priscilla Magdala Torres.
David William Klassman.
Amy Lynn Odell.
Jonathan Clifford Sunderland.
Max James McCorkle.
Edward T. Kramer.
Michael R. Lynch.
Jonathan Raymond McKee.
Roger Owen DeBoer.
Nathaniel Z. Miller.
Alex Lloyd Preston.
Carol Ann Elizabeth Norris.
Troy Allen Coakley.
Jonathan C. Walker.
Anthony James Labono.
Kurt K. Williams.
Olivia Margaret Elizabeth Brown.
Nicholas Jacob Greif.
Jennifer Ann Blasey.
Hannah Marie Wies.
Scott Andrew Potcher.
Justin Dean Yupa.
Brandon Michael Platt.
David Anthony Westhoff.
Ryan Williams Dickey.
David Arden Greiner.
Nathan Lucas Nuzum.
Gregory James Tree.
Sean Thomas Rasmussen. Justin Todd Moffitt.
J.T. Vreeland.
Grant August Hagen.
Gregory Valdez Schwammen.
Todd Arnold Kingston.
Spencer L. Pfeiffer.
Joshua Andrew McNabb.
Michael John O'Brien.
Brian Perry.
Skyler Joseph Riemann.
Kyle Raymond Deeney.
Shishir Gupta.
Stefan Pierce Custer.
Cody Edward Opadal.
Alex Joseph Spencer.
Louis Eugene Naudet.
Joseph Kevin Letchford.
Michael Charles South.
Paul Eric Hart.
Christine Marie Bauer.
John Anthony Grotkin.
Zachary Jacob Stern.
Andrew Melvin Anderson.
James Donald Ortiz.
Eric Lee Gleason.
Elliot James Combs.
David E. Mindham.
Amanda Carol Mahacek.
Adam John Ruland.
Amy Lynn Siroka.
Abdu Jafar Shaikh.
Jordan Michael Boddicker.
Alex Carl Rano.
Sean Michael Pierce.
Arthur M. Feister.
Charles Blair Locken.
Colin Joseph Howe.
Austin Bradley Cudworth.
Brenton Eugene Hankins.
Li Ping Yo.
Harsh Goh.
Yu Ni Ong.
Joshua Frederick Toman.
Chong Chun Yong.
Daniel John Montgomery.
Yuan Qin Lai.
Paul Grant Merkel.
Lowell Dean Stutzman.
Coleman Salvatore Lang.
Edward Nicholas Malek.
Brian Robert Rucka.
Tristan Lewis McLeod.
Sungwoo Kim.
Ryan Kenneth Mum.
Ryan Michael Nelson.
Kevin Fitzpatrick Williamson.
Emily S. O'Keefe.
Eric Samuel Berger.
Kyle Jeffrey White.
Mehawish Alekalil.
Tyler Wade Knapp.
Angela Wambue Mugenda.
Andrew David Sticka.
Curtis Lee Mayberry.
Lucas D. Fatka.
Jordan R. Pascale.
Nicholas David Wetzel.
Brittany Ray Horek.
Brett M. Wetzel.
Shibing Chow.
Ahmed Shakir Al-Nosser.
Ing Chu.
Ahmed Khalil Al-Kashem.
Elfas Song.
Maisha Nicole Rosenberg.
Paige Marie Ledger.
Jared Douglas Hageman.
Lars Eric Ellingson.
Alan E. Graves.
Shun Yoshida.
Samantha Ray Beery.
Benjamin Michael Wolf.
Mark Anthony Burns.
John Robert King.
Michael Allen Healy.
Katie Kerrigan Githens.
Diogratius Emil Mapinge.
Nicholas Christopher Jackson.
Abdulmagid Hussein Youssef.
Pratik Banagar.
Chije Ho.
Robert Michael Casper.
Yang Jang.
Kevin James Hancock. Anthony James Tong. Yu Gao. Lanting Li. Wei Zhang.
I again want to congratulate all of the graduates from the College of Engineering. Our faculty and staff join me in wishing you the very best, and we urge you to stay in touch.
Next, the College of Human Sciences. Dean Pamela White will present the college's student marshal to President Geoffroy.
President Geoffroy and Provost Hoffman, the first student to receive a diploma from the College of Human Sciences is our student marshal, Heather Sinclair. She's escorted today by Dr. Sarah Marchetti, an assistant professor in the Department of Apparel, Events, and Hospitality Management. Heather, the daughter of Brian and Deborah of Mount Pleasant, Iowa, is graduating cum laude with a Bachelor of Science in Apparel, Merchandising, and Design Production, and Journalism and Mass Communication with a minor in Event Management. While at Iowa State, Heather had 5 internships. Among them were positions at Ann Taylor and Trachtenberg and Company in New York. She also found time to study abroad in Italy. Heather's list of leadership contributions is even more impressive and included team leader for Destination Iowa State, marketing and sponsorship coordinator for Closets Collide, alumni and industry relations director for the Iowa State University Fashion Show, and volunteer flagline coach for Nevada High School. Heather is a perfect example of the excellence displayed by the graduates of the College of Human Sciences. Please join me in congratulating Heather.
Kelly Christine Sallow.
Caitlin Christine Haight.
Elizabeth Josephine Martin.
Amy Jo Borkowski.
Teresa Jean Wehoff.
Allison Marie Backus.
Samantha Jo Johnson.
Jennifer Ann Brock.
Nicole Lee McIntosh.
Amanda Ray Duncan.
Andrea L. Fox.
Hannah Marie Porth.
Ashley J. Jo Constanzo.
Mackenzie Ann Moan.
Evan Samuel Pilch.
Emma Claire Ochenbruns.
Michael Ray Bunton.
Kylie Faye Rohde.
Ashley Ann Bowl.
Jamie Lynn Brown.
Sarah Melissa Orzechowski.
Emily Jane Dix.
Kelly Jo Kay.
Allison Casey Watts.
Lindsay D. Frodima.
Tiffany Ann Johnson.
Jennifer Lee Vandenkamp.
Krista Lynn Mader.
Jennifer Leanna Stahl.
Ashley Mikhail Mesnard.
Alexander J. Meyer.
Rebecca D. Gomez.
Winimini George Zarapegi.
Jason Andrew Greeno.
Erica Jean Devine.
Jared D. Zimmerman.
Ananda Joshua Rozewski.
Jacqueline Joanne Schultz.
Wu Jin.
Michelle Lee German.
Don Don Lee.
On behalf of the faculty and staff of the College of Human Sciences, I want to congratulate all the graduates. We know we can expect great things from you as you go forth and expand human potential.
And now, the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences. Dean David Oliver will present the college's student marshal to President Geoffroy.
President Geoffroy, Provost Hoffman, the first student to receive a diploma for the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences is our student marshal, Alex Fitzgerald, a senior graduating summa cum laude with a major in music. He is escorted today by Janet Alcorn, Associate Professor of Voice Emerita in the Department of Music and Theater. Alex Fitzgerald has been involved in music groups on campus, including the Iowa State Singers, which took him to Minneapolis, Oklahoma City, Cincinnati, and South Korea for vocal concerts. He's also been a member of Shy of a Dozen, an outstanding male a cappella group that he has participated in all 4 years while at Iowa State. During the last three summers, Alex has worked at the Interlochen Arts Academy at Michigan, where he rose from being an employee to being a supervisor to being manager of the front of the house office. As manager, he was in charge of 15 staff members and coordinated concerts and performances for artists like Dierks Bentley, the Decemberists, and Elvis Costello. This semester, Alex has been student teaching at Waukee High School and the Parkview and Prairie Ridge Middle Schools in Ankeny. Alex says his experience has reaffirmed his passion as an educator. After graduation, Alex will be substitute teaching while pursuing a full-time teaching position. He wants to work with middle school and high school choirs. Congratulations, Alex.
Jocelyn Michelle Ashrell.
Ross A. Loving.
Benjamin Joseph Kane.
Leanna Renee Prudencio.
Brent Kiel Aronson.
Justine Joanna Anders.
Austin James Miracle.
Angelica Rose Nixt.
Natasha N. Gunaskara.
Rachel Annetta Pratt.
Allison Michaela Hansen.
Caitlin Elizabeth Pritchard.
Mario Myers Winburn.
Alyssa Ann Howitt.
Jill Ann Kudelka.
Kalechi Keith Osemele.
Catherine Lorraine Barber.
Sarah Beth German.
Macy Nicole Meyer.
Michael Clark Soka.
Lindsay K. Rising.
David Thongvan.
Sarah Beth Banwart.
John Paul Bannister.
Emily Nicole Bloomquist.
Krista Lynn Ballack.
Hannah Elizabeth Renner.
Amanda Rachel Rayburn.
Samuel John Wengren.
Chase Michael Green.
Anmal Singh Sandhu.
Diana Ray Martinez.
Mindy Mae Peck.
Joseph Stafford Peterson.
Caitlin Lee Thacker.
Aaron Edward Platt.
David T. Merrill.
John Jesse Hoyt.
Andrew Patrick Sevchek.
Austin Graham Narber.
David Allen Fox.
Kevin Daniel Marquardt.
Jordan E. Schmidt.
Brooke Ann Keenest.
Alyssa Michelle Gilkey.
Caitlin Marie Van Dame.
Vincent Charles Jr.
Emily Ann Chambers.
Jessica Ann Willemson.
Zachary Gray Sanderson.
Sabina Hawk.
Angela Sue French.
Daniel Ryan Dorr.
Sean Douglas Flack.
Adriana Hadez.
Ryan Michael Story.
Evan Mitchell Humphreys.
Gavin Darrell James Crandall.
Rui Liu.
Adim Jerferik.
David Joseph Dubansky.
Ashley Lynn Rader.
Brianna Ann Dunn.
Patrick Robert Kincaid.
Stephen Mamoon Cote.
Brett William Lyons.
Tiersloch Yok Chumchok.
Benjamin Carl Clough.
David Brian Olson.
Anna Lee Ward.
Jordan Charles Young.
Micah Ray Morgan.
Alicia R. Hendricks.
Jessica Lynn Opine.
Jeff W. Callison.
Mariah Rose Smith.
Anchi Shu.
Christina Renee Dietz.
William Kirvin Larson.
John Frederick Lindstrom.
Samuel James Anderson.
Michelle J. Brobst.
Matthew Lyle Hurley.
Kirsten Michelle County.
Neil Joseph Hewitt.
Brooke Rochelle Palmer.
Kyle Martin Boyens.
Elizabeth Ann Peacock.
Nicholas James Hasty.
Joshua Aaron Harms.
Alex Osmond Germeland.
Spencer Patrick Taylor.
Tyler Robert Flanders.
Micah Ray Boyd.
Brian Adam Welter.
Ryan Brooks Dittmer.
Upasana Das Sarma.
Michael David Gibbons.
Melanie Joy Drentner.
Sophia Lynn Prell.
Jochun Kong. Urunopo Blanche Abalu.
Anna Kai.
I want to congratulate the graduates of the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences. The faculty member in our college join me in wishing you the best upon graduation. Come back and see us soon and keep on learning.
At this time, it's my pleasure to present to you Jeff Johnson, president of the Iowa State University Alumni Association, who will now welcome you as Iowa State's newest alumni.
Congratulations, graduates, class of 2011. You are now alumni of Iowa State University, and you are now mine. Along with your diploma and degree status, you are now alumni for life from this wonderful institution. Today, you also mark another wonderful distinction. You are the last class of Iowa State University to receive your degree under the proud and wonderful leadership of Dr. Gregory L. Geoffroy. Please join me in thanking President Geoffroy and his wife, Kathy, for their outstanding and graceful leadership of Iowa State University. I stand before you today to offer three simple messages and three heartfelt invitations. Message number one, the degree you receive today is really a piece of stock. It will increase in value over time, directly correlated with the reputation of this university. So as alumni, you have to stay connected, stay involved, and abreast of all things that can harm or enhance the value of your degree. We've seen great examples of both impacts in the last few months and over time. Whether it was the situations at Penn State or Syracuse, a Nobel Prize winner being named here at Iowa State, the mishaps surrounding prior visas, the huge win of our Cyclones over number two Oklahoma State. So you know that list goes on. In other words, you are forever connected to this university and it is connected to you. How you perform, the decisions that you make, the decisions we make, will all build the reputation and continuing value of this university, thus the value of your degree. We, along with you, will continue to build the strong and respected reputation of this great university. Message number two, become a part of and utilize the Cyclone Network. I want you to hear this. There are 233,000 living addressable graduates of Iowa State University. These individuals live in all 99 counties of Iowa, in all 50 states and the District of Columbia of the United States, and in more than 140 countries. And they are all a keystroke away on our online directory. They are there for you to assess them and use them as you search for and connect with fellow Cyclones in your workplaces, your new communities, and as you travel and do business. So be sure to remain active with your college, your departments, and your student organizations. Become active members of the association so you can have access to this incredible ready-made network of Cyclones worldwide. Message number three, become a dues-paying member of the association. As you heard today, Jacob Talbot, Dr. Brenda Dury, and many others are already active members of their alumni association. The ISU Alumni Association is the second largest dues-paying alumni association in the Big 12 Conference. So we are a powerful force. We're a powerful network. Our benefits serve you, Iowa State, and other Cyclones, past, current, and future. Your dues are only $30 per year for the first 3 years, so become a member. And by the way, parents, this makes a great holiday gift. Allow Iowa State to stay in touch with you and provide you lifelong service, communication, and opportunities to engage with other Iowa State alumni. Having recently returned from South Africa, I was reminded of the power and the breadth of the Cyclone Network. Running into and getting to visit with our alumni in Cape Town was very impactful for me on many levels. So don't miss out on the unknown opportunities that networking with other Cyclones can and will bring to you and your future. Therefore, wear Cyclone gear. Put your diploma in your office. Put your alumni decal on your vehicle and be sure to obey the speed limit. But also, items of Iowa State are welcomed in your home. Now, the invitations. Number one, and it should be no secret, please join us at the Alumni Center for refreshments. These refreshments are being provided by the cafe restaurant. Following this ceremony, you will be able to receive a free gift after you sign up for your membership, and you may also get your photo made with Cy, and I also encourage you to have your photo made in your cap and gown with the bronze Cy outside the Alumni Center. Invitation number two, I don't think I've mentioned this yet, but become a member. Again, dues are only $30, and we desire to keep you well connected to all things Iowa State. And finally, invitation number three, stay in touch and come back to campus often and come back and be involved. Let us know how we can aid you and serve you. Enjoy your next adventures, and as always, go Cyclones.
Thank you, Jeff. We're now nearing the conclusion of our fall commencement ceremony, and I want to offer my personal congratulations to all of today's graduates and extend my thanks to the many people who have played such an important role in this achievement. I also want to thank Ben Allen for being our commencement speaker and congratulate him for his honorary degree. We greatly appreciate all that he has done for this university and for higher education in Iowa. Well, as you've heard, this is my last commencement as president of Iowa State University, and just like you graduates, I am moving on to a new phase of my life and my next big adventure. I leave the presidency with many wonderful memories of commencements in the past and many other ceremonies that celebrate student achievement and academic achievement. Iowa State is an outstanding university, and it's been an honor, a privilege, and a pleasure for me to serve as president. Iowa State's an outstanding university because of its exceptional faculty, people who are at the leading edge of their disciplines and who are passionate about teaching and learning. Iowa State is an outstanding university because it has tremendous students, students like all of you who are motivated to achieve and to excel and to serve the broader community. Iowa State is an outstanding university because it has an incredible family of alumni, a family that you are now joining, people who have used their education and experiences at Iowa State to become successful in their professions and successful as citizens and leaders, and people who give back generously to support important community and societal causes, including and especially their alma mater. And finally, Iowa State is an outstanding university because of its remarkable tradition of achievement and service, a tradition that dates back to the founding of this institution more than 153 years ago. Iowa State has been a force for positive change in our state, our nation, and the world. Its faculty and alumni have made world-changing discoveries, stunning technological advancements, including the digital computer and the cell phone, miraculous new medicines and pharmaceuticals, major agricultural breakthroughs that have helped the world keep pace with its ever-growing population, and near magical new products and materials that improve the quality of life for all. That tradition is as strong today as ever, and it will continue into the future because of all of you and your successors. Now, before we close today, it's important to recognize the hard work of all of those who made this day possible. Faculty members, advisors, and the fathers, mothers, grandparents, sisters, brothers, spouses, partners, children, and the many friends who have supported these graduates. I ask the graduates to now rise and try to find your family and your friends in the audience and thank them for that support. Please rise. I now ask the audience to rise, the families and friends of these wonderful graduates, and show them your support. Please remain standing as we near the end of our commencement ceremony, and remain standing as the platform party recesses. Thank you all for being part of this very important and significant occasion. And now, with the singing of the bells of Iowa State, I pronounce the fall 2011 commencement at a close.
Please join me in singing the bells of Iowa State. You'll find the words written on the back of your program.